What's good, everybody? Welcome to another episode of Fun with Dumb. I have just gotten back from New York City and confirmed a very special guest, and it's very timely. There's a brand new show on Netflix called XO Kitty, and it's very interesting because it's an American show filmed in Korea. So you get to really kind of, I don't know, it's like the first, I feel like, authentic American show where they show Korea and not some lot in Paramount. You know what I'm saying? And like, so I was watching a little bit of it, and actually one of my homegirls was in the show, and I knew this girl before the show and everything. So this is a legitimate homegirl. I'm not just throwing out the word homegirl. Because my friends roast me for that shit. Oh, she's your homegirl now. Yeah. My homegirl is an actress. Her name is Gia Kim. What's up, Gia?
Hello.
How you feeling?
Good. I'm a little bit nervous.
You're nervous?
I'm very happy to be here. Actually, I have having like imposter syndrome sitting here. I'm like, do I deserve to be sitting here today?
We're nobodies. We are absolutely nobodies.
And it's really cool because, like Dumb said, I don't know where I'm supposed to be looking when I'm talking.
No, you just look at us.
Okay.
Look at
us.
Yeah. I know. I'm nervous.
No. No, because he's actually the only person that's seen me in my previous job
right
on TV. Mm-hmm. And when we met up, because I was a news reporter before, and then he was like, I think I actually saw you on the news when you were doing it. I'm like, no way, because I've never met someone who actually watched.
We're talking about Arirang.
Yeah.
So yeah. Arirang was like this. Actually, it's interesting because Arirang was one of those like crossbreed American Korean networks.
Arirang.
Arirang TV. Yes.
Yeah.
It was like a government funded Korean outlet internationally, right?
Yeah.
And I for some reason watched the show.
Yeah. That's cool. It was really cool. And
did you have Korean news or it was American?
So it was mostly Korean news but in English. So everything was in English. So it was kind of like NHK of Japan or...
It's also that's basically like, for like if there are foreigners living in Korea, they would be watching that in order to keep up with the news and updates on Korea, basically.
Very cool.
Yeah. So it was interesting. And then we became friends and she was just like, you know, going out, doing tons of auditions.
I was in school when we met.
Oh, yeah. Going to school. Mm-hmm. And it was interesting. She's like, yo, I booked this thing. And I was like, yo, it's going to be lit for you. Amazing. And this was like a while ago now.
Yeah.
Finally, it's out. And since then, every day, there's just thousands of followers being, you know, crazy.
Wait. You knew him before me?
Yeah.
I thought, I was like talking to him. I was like,
we met all on the same day, remember?
Yeah, in
we
a crew?
Met at, no. We met at our friend's birthday party together.
Oh, yeah.
We were both there.
When was this?
That's what it was. This like Jungman's birthday.
Yeah, this is like 3 years ago.
I think something around
there. Yeah, whatever. I knew. I'm trying to jump into this. we got Gia Kim and her brother, who's also a co-star on XO Kitty.
Woo!
Yay!
Which is a very rare situation when your sibling gets casted in something. You know what I mean? Yeah. And this is Sang Heon Lee.
Hi.
How you doing, brother?
It just feels weird for a second. Like I couldn't see. Wait, am I supposed to look at the camera?
Yeah, exactly. You want to say your name one more time just so people know your pronunciation? Because I've heard it pronounced so many different ways.
Let's get it right.
So my name is Sang Heon Lee. Mm-hmm. Or you can say in Korean it's Lee Sang Heon. It's not Sang. It's Sang Heon. I actually have a name. It's like if someone has a name Jeffrey, I'm calling him Jeff or Je.
Yeah.
It's call my name correctly if that's.
Let's go, bro.
Not Sang Heon.
Sang Heon.
Sang Heon.
Sang Heon.
Sang Heon. Sang Heon. Like Han, honey,
Han. 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 Hey, Han. Sang Heon.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, Sang Heon. Thanks for jumping on the show. I don't know you that well, so I want to get to know you a little bit before we jump into combos here.
Yeah, sweet.
Because you have an accent.
Yes.
And what is not a Korean accent, a different accent?
It's sort of mixed, I would say. So I was born in Korea, raised in Hong Kong. and I went to university in the UK, which is in England, for like 3 years.
Okay.
And that's how I got this British accent, but it's very mixed, I would say, because I had this American accent when I was in Hong Kong, and she and I think Gia would agree with that as well, but I can't remember me having an American accent. But now I went to UK for 3 years, it just suddenly grew on me so quickly.
Well, you were assimilating, so it's understandable.
Mm. So yeah, when I came back, everyone was like, "What the? who are you, mate?" Like, yeah. So yeah,
that's what it is. It's perfect for this international school. An international school accent.
Yeah, that is.
I didn't go to international school, but that's an international school accent.
That is.
Also, it's funny because when you grow up in Hong Kong, you either grow a standard American accent or a standard British accent. You can go either way. If you grow up in Hong Kong, it depends like what school, what international school you go to.
That's so crazy. Just having no accent, it sounds like you're faking it.
Putting on an accent,
right.
Of us, it's not native, so
that's why people don't probably think you guys are siblings. You guys do look very similar.
If I just
look at you guys, yes. Yeah. But I would never think just because of the accent. You always think like you guys grew up together.
Plus, we have like different last names, especially when it comes up. Yeah. And then, so every time when they ask me like, why is Gia Kim? Like what's the scenario?
Yeah.
And I was always pull this joke, be like, oh, so she's adopted. And they go like, oh. And then I'm like, no, I'm joking. They're like, oh. Like, and then they just fluster. I just love that reaction.
Yeah. I thought it was like a separation at birth thing, you know?
And you reunited
as twins at some point.
That'd be more wild. No. That's too
sweet. Gia Kim is a stage name. I got it from like a 사주선생님 name in Korea. Mm. Like he gave me like five different names.
Mm. I like that you're a stage name, Kim. You could have chosen any last name. You're like, Lee? Kim?
No, because the names come as a full package.
Oh.
Like I can't just switch around this first name and that last name. So it came with like different sets of full names. I just chose one.
Can you explain that to me? So these stage names, it comes pre-packaged.
what are we
talking about right now?
It's a two for one.
You know saju, right? Like saju, it's
4
like,
weeks.
I'm sorry, talk to me. Saju, for those of you don't know, it's like a birth chart reading, but like an Asian version of astrology, I guess. Yeah. I don't really know how they cross over, but they're very similar. A lot of people, like when you have newborn babies or they're about to change their names, like they would go to 사주선생님 and get names based on their birth charts.
Okay, got you.
And then, so I asked for one for my career, because I went with like an English name for the longest time.
Yeah.
I had like five different English names throughout my life until one day I was like, I kind of want a stage name, but also a Korean stage name that would work well in English. So then I went to 선생님 and then he gave me five options. And then Kim Gia was the one that kind of stuck with me. And I was like, oh, Gia Kim works well in English too. So that's why.
I like Gia Kim.
I love Gia.
Good choice. Thank you.
No, but it was also funny how you meant to keep that name so people can pronounce your name clearly, right? Mm-mm. But it was funny because like anytime there was a news article about us, and they will always put Sang Heon Lee, Choi Min Young, all the Korean actors in one.
Lee Sang Heon, Choi Min Young.
But her name's like
Gia
in this.
Kim.
But her name's in like this American like the cast list, like with, along like Anna Kakar, Anthony,
and
Gia Kim.
People think I'm Korean American, and he's from Korea.
I see.
So that's why people completely like don't even know. Where
there's so many factors that divide you.
Exactly.
When did you take on the name Gia Kim?
This was like 4 years ago, like a year before I came to LA.
Do you feel like now that you have the stage, do you feel like there was an evolution or a shift in who you felt as a character or as a person also?
Mm. Yeah.
You did. In what ways were they different from what was the name before?
You don't have to share
Question. I really do like this question because I have had evolutions of names based on the kind of person I thought I was stepping into.
Yeah.
And I've had like five different names, which is why, like, depending on which stage of my life you've known me from, like, they would know me by different names. So then now I've like unified it as guys like call me Gia, right? But then it took a while for everyone to like catch on to all the name changes, and they're like, okay, is this like the last one? Like, because the first English name I used was Helena, which was my Catholic Catholic name, because we're both born and raised Catholic. And then I went by Tongyeon, which is my birth name, because we went back and forth between Hong Kong and Seoul quite a bit as well. And then when I went back, I was like, I don't want to use Helena anymore, because one of my third grade teachers was like shortening everyone's names, and mine was Hel.
Oh my God.
I was like, I was so hurt by that. I was like, oh my God, I don't want everyone calling me Hel.
What the hell?
I mean, they could have gone with Helen
or
something. Name changes are a big thing for me, too, because I went through that as well.
Oh, really?
Let's talk about it.
I actually try to change it. Hey, turn my mic up a little bit, Johnny, real quick.
Yeah, turn them up.
You know, like, as a rapper, you go through a lot of nicknames.
Right, right.
You know, I ended up settling on Dumbfoundead, surprisingly. That was the one I actually chose.
When did you settle that name? Like,
I was 14 years old, and I was kind of a space cadet. I'd, like, zone off into the distance, and they were like, you look Dumbfoundead, and that word sounded so weird. It's like kind of an what little Hogwarts motherfucker said, you look dumbfounded, like, who? Because it's not like a young person word, it's like a like a British like I was dumbfounded, you know. So I don't know what kid actually said that word, but it sounded funny to me, because I was already a class clown, so you know, dumb and dumbfounded sounded funny. So I went with that name, and then when I turned around 30 years old, I wanted I was like, it's kind of a silly name. So I try to go by Parker.
Oh.
And I try to go with Parker, and none of my fans was letting me have that.
Oh, really? Yeah. Oh, my God.
So I started, my acting name, I go by Jon Park.
Right.
Which is short for Jonathan.
Right.
And even with John, I wasn't happy, because it's such like a basic first name. Yeah. Uh-huh. So I was like playing with Jonathan. Maybe I was like, I can go with Nathan, which is the second half of Jonathan.
Oh, I didn't know this.
I consider that. Maybe I could go with Johnny. Or maybe I'll go with Jean, like Jean, like a French Jean. I'll be Jean Park. But then people are gonna ask me, like, what are your French origins? And I'm gonna have to be like, no, I just liked Jean. So I decided to scrap that, and I'm just Jon Park.
Yeah.
Jon Dumbfounded Park.
John. Nathan would have been so funny.
Nathan.
It matches your cardigans that you wear.
But you don't use Hongman at all.
Right? Hongman, which is my Korean name. Yeah. A lot of people didn't know that. You didn't have to drop them on like that.
Wait, you don't like
that's
it?
That's your Korean name?
It's Hongman.
Hongman?
Yeah. Hongman.
Bro, that's some kusuan name.
Yeah, dude.
What does that mean?
Jung Chi Kuo, no? Yeah. Hongman이 형 때렸어.
Wait, what is that? Why don't you explain to the English listener?
Okay. Like, kusuan means like very very local, like very very like, local, like so local. I don't
like
know.
Common?
Well, the word itself, if you describe it to as a taste, it's like very like
homey, like
proteiny,
right?
Nutty kind of
nutty.
Right? I know it as a
I got a nutty name.
Yeah, nutty. Name Nathan.
You nut.
It's like very friendly.
Yeah,
friendly.
Very friendly. Yeah. Yeah. Very friendly.
Very like, yeah, it feels like home.
I mean,
that's so true.
Look, I am a hometown.
So
I'm a very hometown guy.
Yeah.
People know me.
You know.
Yeah. Okay. Anyway. I want to change this real quick. Change the subject. Let me ask you guys. So, how did you two get casted in this as siblings?
You want to go first?
Okay, so towards the end of my school, I was just starting to look for auditions, because in school I couldn't. And then the open casting call came up on my Instagram post, and then I started seeing it a few other places. I was like, you know, it's a long shot. It's a high schooler. It's been a minute since I've graduated high school, but I'm just going to go for it. And there was only one character that I could qualify for anyways.
Yeah.
So then I did it. It was around Thanksgiving last year. And then they pinned me really quickly. I was like, oh, like something's happening here, right? And then I forwarded it immediately to Sang-hon, because I saw the breakdown, and one of the characters was perfect for him.
Wait, and were you an aspiring actor as well?
He was already out.
So I studied drama in high school, and then I took in university, I was taking drama as well.
Okay, okay.
But I didn't get serious until after university.
Gotcha.
Yeah, like after university, it was military. And after military,
modeling.
It was a year and a half of modeling. And I did that because I needed money in order to keep pursuing this acting thing. And acting in Korea or anywhere, in the beginning, it's just you don't get jack shit.
Your
wallet's always thin. Right. So I didn't want that. So I've always just had this mind where, okay, let me get this amount of money in this bank account, and then I'll start acting. And that's when I've achieved that goal. And then it's weird enough how she sent me this post, coincidentally, literally on the timing when I've just... Yeah. Now I feel like, okay, now I'm gonna start acting.
Yeah.
So she sent me this, is it right? Is it the continuation right?
Yeah.
So that's when she sent me this Instagram post. It was like open cast call. And she said, I just got pinned. You should go for it. And then I remember her telling me this like a month ago. And this was like the time where I was like, oh yeah, I'll definitely go. But I forgot about what she said.
Right.
and then it turns out I have like 3 days until deadline for the tape.
Oh, shit. It never happened.
Yeah, and then that's when she was like, please tell me you sent your tape. I was like, I didn't. Oh, I forgot about this. And she's like, oh my gosh, I just got pinned. Can you please just go for it? And I was like, all right, fine. But the thing is, right, back then I thought, what are the chances?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
It's an open cast call.
Yeah.
It's going to be filming in LA.
Right.
And I'm a nobody. Like, who's going to cast me?
Yeah.
So that's when I thought, yeah. I was literally not gonna go for it, but then last minute I was like, okay, what have I got to lose?
So they didn't know you guys were siblings.
No.
Interesting.
Well, yeah, also because the different last name. Yeah.
That's true. And I was auditioning from LA and he was in Seoul.
Korea.
So
that's
crazy. Like cast as the local and he was an international. I think that's why people think I'm Korean American and the media started writing my name as like.
Can you take us through like the process of what you did during the audition? Did you make it unique in any way or were there lines that you had to memorize or?
Oh yeah.
They gave us like 3-4 scenes in the breakdown, which was already a lot.
A lot. That's a lot. That's a lot.
And each of them were with the other core characters. And
the lines, they were chunky. Like, they were fairly chunky lines.
The chunky lines.
And
one was like pretty emotional for me too.
Mm.
And was it the same? Did you play the character? Did you guys shift a bit of the character once you were on set? Or like you talked to the director? Like, or was it similar to like what you auditioned for as the character?
It was definitely, for me it was, I think I leaned more into like the peer side for the auditions.
Uh-huh.
And then one of the scenes, I think with my mom, was like an emotional scene. And in the auditions, like the second, third, fourth, the chemistry reads and things like that, when it got there like 3 months later, it was, they were asking to kind of like go in between like the, like, you know, kind of leveling out the different sides of the character more. And then I think in the last audition we did, well, at least for me, I don't know if they made you improvise the Korean.
No, I mean, I remember them asking if you can do a Korean and I tried it, but I think I failed miserably.
Actually, it's interesting because both of you guys got these parts and both of you guys are supposed to be kind of like a kind of characters,
basically,
right?
Way, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yours is scary to me.
Yeah.
Yours is relatable. Like when I watch, the show was great.
Yeah.
I think it's so fun and it's, you know, I think like if I was a kid and I got to see someone like you guys on TV, so normally it would have made me feel so like inspired to do this work, you know?
Well, hold on. You were, because your real life personality is way more
so
sweeter
bubbly,
and bubblier than the character on there. So I definitely saw a shift there. You, I don't know that well. You already look like you'd be in the Slytherin house at Hogwarts. You know what I mean? You put blonde on, you're full villain.
Yeah.
You put blonde on this guy, he's full villain.
I wanted to ask you, because we got you here. Both of you guys, to me, are RBF champions. You guys know what RBF is?
The resting face
that you guys have. And, you know, and I don't say this offensively. No, like in
no,
the beginning.
I'm not offended.
You know, like in the shop, when that lady tells you about like, oh, 아빠가 이거 안 좋아할 건데, you know, and you gave her the RBF face. So I want to learn from you guys. Just give me a few pointers right now on this pod.
Let's practice a line. Let's do a line. We'll teach you and let's have a line set.
I want to look as mean as possible.
Yes.
What do you do? How do you mentally get there?
Is he starting to do it?
Oh my God! Somebody young.
No! I got
All right.
Did I just said that was fucking scary. Like, I consider myself to be a confident, cool motherfucker. I started like fixing my posture and what the
Oh my god.
I was like, did I do something?
Yo, seriously, okay.
Where were you going? Yeah, where did you go? Yeah. Where did your head go? Did you have to think or was
No,
this
I just wanted to like relax and then
That's what it is, the up down. Wow.
That's scary.
Yeah, but we really don't make this face out in public, do we? Like
what?
Like the resting bit.
I don't think so.
Yeah, exactly. Because like it's too mean sometimes. Like there's some people, and I've seen your resting face quite a lot.
Oh,
like, like no, as in like sometimes like if we're having fun, and I sometimes look at you, I'm like, are you okay?
Yeah,
like, are you having fun?
Yeah.
But no, she's like, I'm having so much fun. I'm like, are you like? Look at you, man.
Gia's very introspective. That's what.
Yeah, that is
no,
true.
No. It's he's talking about when we're like out partying, and then my body's really tired, but my mind, my still wants to dance, right? Like body wants to dance, but my mind is tired. I'll be like.
The autopilot.
You're on autopilot.
Let me see your resting.
Yeah, let's see.
Face.
See your resting face.
No, wait, hold on.
Nah.
That's Songman face, dude.
Fuck. Rick, that's a rice bowl face, bro. That is a. What are you talking about, bro? That is a rice bowl.
Another thing about you, Gia, what I realized that you do really well. You roll your eyes like a. You roll your eye like in that car scene when you're talking to her.
Yeah.
Just like every other second, you got like.
Well, I think the cadence of way you were talking was so different than what I'm used to talking to you on this show. You know what I mean? Like that's why I was like, "Damn, you are a good actor."
Oh, totally.
Shinjaro, like no. We were like, "Wow, yeah."
Yeah, because you know some people could just play themselves.
Exactly.
Like I'll hop in some shit. It's usually they always like want to like me to play kind of myself.
Yeah.
All the roles I get is like stoner, hacker. You know.
He actually got an audition for Pachinko, and he had to play he had to play the pastor.
What's
you
a pastor?
You guys, the pastor.
Oh, pastor.
Yeah, Moksanim.
Yeah. It was like a Moksanim. It was like
really.
Yeah, but it was. Like,
but it was
I
so
had to
funny.
Try so hard. Like to play this character.
Oh, wow.
You know, I'm taking out my nose ring. I'm fixing my hair, covering my tattoo.
He's like, does it look like I believe in God?
Honestly,
I don't know why fixing my hair has to change my whole religious status.
I don't think someone with that kind of eyebrow could ever be a pastor. Like, there's requirements.
It's an eyebrow thing?
There's requirements to be a pastor. You can't have that thick of the eyebrows to be
How
a pastor for some reason.
Hair?
What is it in a pastor that you see has certain physical traits?
Well, their eyebrows need to be lighter, dude. Just because. Like, no, the reason why is because when a pastor's too expressive, like. You know what I'm talking about? If they're too
you look too judgmental. You could be judgmental.
Yeah, you look judgmental.
Like you have to have the only God can judge you eyebrows. Yeah, the only God can judge you eyebrows.
100%.
Yeah. I've never seen a pastor with PAMA hair.
Yeah. First of all, this is natural. It's not PAMA. Right? Relax.
No, I mean you could play like a pastor who's been through some
shit. Yeah. They've through some shit.
Some shit.
Yeah. You know, and now you're like enlightened after that. You
like
know?
I just got out of jail. I've been converted.
Yeah.
I exactly. See. Like, I want to live the good life. Now.
You're basically saying he looks like that right now.
No, I mean, it's so hard to go with the aesthetics.
All right. But let me ask you. You guys got to shoot in Korea, and it's kind of a dream role for me because I love being in Korea.
Mm.
And I don't speak good Korean, so
yeah,
that would be like a dream role. Except this role, you have to kind of speak both pretty well, right?
In a way, yeah.
And you guys both do speak pretty well on both.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
her more than you.
I think
no,
you speak good enough.
We're both fluent, but I
but
think
yeah,
that
like okay. So if we were to speak Korean with actual Korean people, like the locals,
yeah,
they would honestly say. You grew up somewhere else, didn't you?
Yeah, they hear a bit of like
they were 100%.
Some of the lir sounds or some. Jiut sounds, it would be like ja as opposed to ta and like things like that. Like very like acting teachers could point it out to
right.
me.
Yeah,
you know?
I hate
but
it.
Also like I was more used to acting in English, so the Korean scenes were more stressful for me.
Did
personally.
You have to did you have like a teacher on or some did you
coach?
Ask about
We had an acting coach who's also a really good friend of ours, Daniela. So she was like Korean American, so she would like kind of be with our kind of moral support on set as well.
Oh, and was that something the production already had set up, or is that?
I think not from the beginning.
It was around at the beginning of like block one or block two.
End of our prep phase. I mean,
I would say like I think acting in Korean is different too.
Yeah,
there's so many different little nuanced mannerisms that you have to understand
for sure.
And for sure, like if I would do it, they would need somebody to teach me how to be Korean, like on set. Like
that's what was so fascinating to watch your mother character. Mm. You know, she's a very famous actress in Korea.
Yeah.
But to see her speak English, and
that was nuts.
She was good.
She was really good. Yeah. Had a beautiful, like an amazing, strong voice. But it was just like. That shift was so interesting to see, and to see her act, right? And I wondered if she had to shift any of the mannerisms to match more of like the American or the general like Western appeal of acting, because there is a different form of acting, I would say.
I mean, I think personally, because I hadn't watched Lost when it was really big. So if I had watched that first and then seen her Korean, then maybe it would have been weirder for me to see that shift. But because I was used to seeing her in Korean and I hadn't seen her act in English, for me as well, I was like, oh, like this is really, you know. But I don't know. I don't know if she, I don't know. I think she, because she's also comfortable in both languages.
I will say the, you know, watching this, I've only saw one episode. So excuse me for not watching the whole season yet. But also I did that on purpose because they watched a lot more episodes. And I was like, I should be the person who didn't watch the same episode to give a different perspective.
We'll balance it out.
It's not laziness. It's for the purpose. I call it being a good journalist. So anyways, I was watching it. And from what I've seen, they've done a really good job with you guys' character and the mom too, from some of the best transition from Korean into English.
Yeah,
it feels the most natural that I've seen in a lot of other things.
Yeah.
Is it? Oh wow.
Thank you.
Your Konglish is very good, you know what I mean? Yeah, definitely. That's my dialect pretty much.
Yeah,
you are a professional Konglish. You are King Konglish.
I'm King Konglish.
King Konglish.
Yeah, King Konglish. Yeah.
It's so weird too. Just let's talk about the aesthetics of the show, right? Like it's a very American show in Korea, which usually like Korean dramas or Korean shows, there's like a Tukihan Korean feel to it, right? But this one, just like the set, like the colors and everything, it just feels very like Saved by the Bell, like new generation.
So it's a different. You're saying it's a different way shot.
It was different the other way.
For me, it was more the other way. Wow. I felt like, it's Korean. This is a Korean drama in English that people can actually finally. Korean
as well.
You think it was shot Korean drama esque
because of like the outfits and like the hairpin, like. You know, I can't imagine the colors, the color schemes.
Yeah.
Kind of similar to these colors.
Exactly.
And so I thought that was fascinating to see that kind of juxtaposition.
Yeah.
And I really enjoyed it. And I can't wait to see more of this thing that you guys kind of start. I felt like you guys started this, you know?
Well, I mean, that's like shout out to the production people and the directors and the writers, because the directors, all of them had really like studied K-dramas to kind of catch the feeling, like what makes K-dramas and there are specific moments you can definitely see they aim, like they gun for this to be a K-drama moment kind of situation. So I think that's, they did a really good job of combining.
I mean, that works, you know what I mean? There's a formula that the Koreans have figured out, and that works. I am the only Korean who hasn't figured out a formula for success. I'm like, how did y'all figure this out and garnering millions of views, and I've been in this for 15 plus years, and yet I'm like a scientist still trying to figure out the formula. Anyways, I want to ask you guys, because in the last few days since Thursday, today is Tuesday, it's been crazy. I'm sure it's been insane, like few days for you guys, going from like, you know, a few thousand followers to,
you're talking about Instagram.
I mean, just socials, all socials. Yeah. You know, a million.
He hit a million on the fourth day.
On the fourth day. That's crazy, though.
You have Sangha Pool in a British accent. What do you think? What do you think is gonna happen, bro? You have the cheat code, bro, and you're tall, man. Relax, bro. Don't look at me.
Yeah, I'm just saying. Yeah, I mean, you do already kind of look like a you know handsome Korean K-pop star.
Yeah, you already look like
you know the formula. But I mean, you went last 2 days too. You went to 350K.
Yeah,
I've been following your socials. Yeah. I followed you when you were less than 2,000 or something.
Less than 1,000.
Less than 1,000.
Okay, so I had another Instagram account, then I made a public one. So we were friends before I made the public account.
Come on, when did you know her? I knew her since 200 followers, fam.
Didn't you say that you have more followers than Dumb now? Like,
I'm like, before I came, I was like, I realize I have more followers than Dumb
I'm
now.
Not mad. I'm not mad, guys. Like, I am not mad. Yeah. But I am proud of you. I'm very proud of you.
No, it's incredible.
No, because we met for coffee like a few years ago. And that was like the first kind of real conversation we had after meeting out. And then that's like I was still talking to you about like how it's like to juggle school and be in school, and like I was gonna, you were like, oh, what do you want to do after you graduate? And like,
yeah, yeah. I was being a little mentor, a little goodwill hunting, if you will. don't worry about it, kiddo. Keep going at it. Go for the big dogs. Netflix. That's where it's at. No, I didn't say none of that.
And but, you were talking about your show, and you were trying to.
Yeah, but she was so nice that I was always like, I was very supportive. You know what I mean? It's like I would be a little bit rougher with like average know, people, but she's a very sweet person, and she was very driven. You know, going like really after it. So. I was super nice, and then when I found out about this, I actually auditioned for EXO Kitty too.
I know, yeah.
Wait, character. Wait.
I auditioned for the professor role.
No, that's another thing. You
Where there's really? Two professors, which one? There's one that is so young-looking to me.
The younger
he
one.
Looks almost like the student. I get confused when I watch it.
He's actually younger than
us.
He looks really young.
Yeah. So it was like the professor who's supposed to be like kind of like cool. Young, cool, good-looking.
Okay, so it must have been that one.
The cool professor. One.
Yeah.
Young, cool, and good-looking.
I do get shy when sometimes the role reads like, good looking or handsome, because you're just like, okay, now I gotta like this shit. Because it's like, it's also like, are people gonna look through the audition and be like, this guy's not good looking, get him out of here, you know? It's just like, so I get all shy about that. But the professor thing is funny too, because I always feel youthful, you know? So I don't feel I'm old enough to be a professor, but I don't feel like that, you know? So I got to play up the adultness.
Maybe art class or drama, you know what I mean? Maybe art class or drama theater.
Youth pastor?
Relax, bro. We already talked about it.
The youth pastor could have wild eyebrows, right? Like, I've seen some
exactly.
I also can see you as like a PE teacher.
Yeah.
Oh, like a gym teacher with the high socks.
Yeah.
He said now. What? I couldn't be a PE teacher.
No,
before.
I'm saying you in shape. You in beautiful shape.
What would
shape
be
now.
Like your dream role?
Oh, that's that's a good question.
Dream. You know what? I think I play up the parts of myself that I want to be in. I want to be like an action star.
I talked about action this before. Yeah,
you know, and but that's a little
like
bit tougher.
Marvel action or like Die Hard action.
I want to be like a fun action hero, like Deadpool. You know, Ryan Reynolds.
Oh yeah,
like he's edgy, but he's also saving the day.
Yeah. Like you kill him and then have a catchphrase or something.
Yeah.
You know?
What would be my catchphrase?
I don't know.
I kill the guy. You know,
don't be dumb. I don't know. something.
Found dead by dumb. Right? Or something. Just something stupid.
Let's go.
Like, I don't know. Yeah, just something fun where I could kind of be myself.
Yeah,
but a heightened version of it, I guess.
Right. Yeah.
What would be a dream role for you guys?
I don't know. I think I don't really have a dream role. It's just...
Yeah, because you're kind of just jumping into this brand new thing.
It really is, But I'm glad that we jumped into comedy first, because apparently... People say the comedy, the genre itself is the hardest one.
You're good at comedy.
Yeah, but apparently it's the hardest one to play it out. It's hard to make someone laugh or whatever.
Yeah.
You can, anyone can portray that they're mad or they're pissed off or like act crazy. But apparently just portraying comedy itself on screen is so hard. But naturally, I think me and Gia, we've watched so many comedy genres like Friends, like films, so I think we've got a great understanding of it. So
I mean, so we are really silly when we're just the two of us together, like really silly, like we can't show how silly we are to other people, But
oh, that's elite. Yeah.
But I think he does a better job of leaning, like actually using that comedic instinct on set. Mm. Because to me, I get kind of like caught up in my head too much when I act. I am a very heady person, right, which is something that I always have to work on. But he just like uses his instincts and like just does it.
But yeah, you can just say that I'm the star where I wing it, and you're very analytical.
Which is great.
Yeah, because she's on that. Good. She's on that theatrical like Juilliard.
No.
Because she really. You know one thing I know about you too. You could cry.
Oh yeah,
you could cry. I think I've seen you cry one time.
What'd you do?
No. Okay. We were just hanging out, and you just started crying. I was
really?
Like, it wasn't even a sad moment. She's like, "No, I'm happy."
That's the scariest
one.
You know your. I feel like anyone who could do that are just like great actors. Oh, yeah. When they could tap into those emotions.
When did I cry? I forget. In front of you?
I forget. You were crying. I was like, "What the
really?
F***? We're just getting ice cream, and she's just like, "I'm just happy."
This is not surprising at all.
I know it's not surprising, but I don't remember crying in front of him.
Over a honey meat?
No, she will eat a kimchi chigae and cry. I'm like, the flavors. I'm like, what?
The numul drops in the kungmul.
I've seen some kungmul numuls. I've seen some kungmul numuls, bro.
Nah, but seriously, good actors could do tears of joy. You know what I mean? Tears of sadness is easier than tears of joy.
No, you're really passionate, and you tap into those emotions. Oh, you can find joy in anything and sadness in anything.
Mm. Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I accidentally step on a plant and she'll just start crying. Like, that plant won't ever grow another leaf. It's like, what? It's just crazy, you know? Wow. She'll leave the pod today. It's like, she'll be like, we'll never have that moment again. What?
What are the British accents?
I don't know what the British accents are.
We'll never have that moment again. Yeah.
No. But I feel like, yeah, I mean, you have that. And then you have this kind of natural, you really are that role.
Yeah.
I think so.
That posh kind of pompous, you know.
Chill, relax, baby.
Although, okay,
I haven't seen much of it yet. You know, the range of the character. I've only seen one episode, but.
I had to play it very posh. That is definitely because I'm not that posh in some ways. Mm-mm. So I had even a dialect coach where she taught me how to be posh and how to speak poshly.
Could you give us a little like few tidbits? Like how did you, what kind of advice did they give you to kind of make you a little more posh?
First of all, I think it's just like the most obvious one is the posh people. They pronounce the T in a stronger way, so it's like water or like can you get some water please
that T sounds like you just spit in my eye. water. Oh, god damn, you posh motherfucker just spit in my eye.
That's a good one.
Yeah,
probably like posture too, right? Like
all that.
Yeah, I mean people when we're asked like, oh, who's the most similar to their character, everyone chooses him, but it's like, yes, he likes what he likes. He's a Taurus. He likes, you know, luxurious, you know, comfortable life. He likes but he's not like pretentious.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, so sometimes I do get offended when people are like, that's you. I'm like, no, not really.
And
yeah.
He's also like a softie in terms of love, and he's not as much of a playboy as he is in the show.
Mm. Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Maybe not in front of you.
He's your brother.
She's a good Nuna.
He's like, she doesn't know anything about me. I get quite a lot of bitches.
No, it's bitches.
Yes.
Nah, but yo, I say this with all respect, like. There's a role I see. You remind me of like the antagonist in Old Boy. You know what I mean?
Mm. Oh,
like the guy with the master revenge plot.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I see you.
This
playing
character
like
right here. He's on the poster.
Yeah.
You just tell the good looking
evil guy.
Yeah. I think you could also play a protagonist. Like I imagine you like having the dual thing, something happen, like in a Disney movie or something like that. You know, that switches something bad, like a parent dies and then you're like, you know. And then you start from a prince, and then that, and then
Shrek.
And then
yeah.
You should play.
Not Shrek. I meant Hulk.
I was like Shrek. Wait,
what? Just call your brother an ogre.
I was like, I did not. Oh man, I see both.
That's hilarious.
Yeah, yeah. No, I think you're gonna get. You could definitely be like a. You could have been Cowboy Bebop.
Yeah,
you know what
I
mean.
I haven't watched that. I've seen that on Netflix. I haven't watched
that. That could have been a cool because it's based on the anime. You know, he's kind of like you, like a lanky, cool. Mm. Like, right. Yeah, you look like you should have a cigarette with you right now.
Yeah, always
just hanging out. You know?
Steph, what's your dream role?
I would like to play like a psychological thriller where I am someone who comes off one way and is actually the other way. Yeah. I want to be able to like. I want to like do a serious role.
I can imagine her in like Kill Bill or something. Right.
The hair, I think. It's the little hair thing.
I picture you like in one scene just running down the hall with the lights flickering. You know, like, just like running. If you know what I'm talking about? And then like if the camera's here, you come all the way up to the camera like, I
picture her, like knowing her, she's kind of like, she has these crazy eyes sometimes. I see her in like a Gone Girl.
Ooh. Oh, yeah.
Like,
here's she slits the neck. She's like a very like composed lady who's very like kept together, but then she's actually like a killer.
she does
not give a fuck.
Yeah. Wow.
Here's the premise. I got the perfect premise for you. All right, here we go. So you come in as the new nanny for this white family, right? Straight from Korea, doesn't speak a lick of English. And throughout the weeks, there's something not right about you, but you're also seducing the father. You're messing with, you're poisoning the mom and the kids' foods. And then plot twist at the end, you speak perfect English.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah. Yo, that's kind of tight.
And you're getting revenge on this family because the family's company somehow destroyed your family back home in Korea.
Wow.
Come on.
Let's write
dude.
It.
You guys should write a movie together.
The fob.
The fob.
The fob
maid.
The fob
maid. Yeah. The fob.
I like that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I there can you see go. You do all those roles.
Oh, my dream
you.
Role.
Thank you. I hope so.
If I was to ever get a part, I want to play, you know, the No Country for Old Men, the killer, the bad guy.
What?
The guy with the hair that just goes around killing people.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, like Javier, you know what I mean?
Yeah, Javier Bardem.
I don't know. I want to play like a psychotic killer.
You guys got a similar head shape, too.
Shut the fuck up.
You and Javier,
he has a huge head, I get it.
No, I'm not talking about hugeness, talking about the shape. That's a Javier head right there. That's a Javier head, bro.
What is a head?
Head
talk to him, man.
It's just like a punctuation you throw at the end.
Oh, yeah. I see.
You know, when you can't really finish the description. Like, a head ass, you know?
Okay, you thick eyebrow head ass. It's always an adjective, a description, and then head ass.
It's almost like a punctuation.
Okay. Yeah. It's useless. Don't use it.
Let it go.
I've never heard this before.
Is this a must be like American?
It's okay.
Like,
it's like we're really describing it to international students here. No. Let me ask you this. If we were at an international school and we were the students, like what kind of, who would we be? What kind of students? Like what, like in this school? You know?
I can definitely imagine you guys straight away. Rugby.
Rugby.
Wow. Yeah, rugby.
Let's go.
All the way.
High school rugby player.
I would say, I think one of the cool hippie, cool
really
group.
Playful, like has
hipster, like yeah, rock. She's into indie rock, maybe.
Yeah, I
she's
can definitely see within you the cool being group, like though. Really
sick.
Okay, shit.
Cute.
And then dumb. I think you would be. Okay, let's see. Dumb.
I can see him like sitting on the steps, like eating snacks.
Wait, alone? What the?
No,
is he background? Like, what? Is he a background actor?
One day these kids will pay. These kids will pay, I tell you.
Because at my high school there were these giant steps where everyone could hang out during recess there. Yeah. You know what I mean? I could just see you like not giving a f- just like eating snacks.
He's flaming hot Cheetos. Just
But he's alone.
No, I can definitely think that you would be another cool group. I think you have
I'm so cool that I have no friends. I'm so cool. I don't need friends. I'm way cooler than every one of these guys.
Literally, they just said athlete, cool guy, stairs.
Oh, better question is,
who would our parents be?
Ooh.
Because international school is kind of like your parents are doing something interesting. That's why you're in international school, right? Right, like, right. Because they have like particular jobs. Like, you know what I mean?
Interesting.
What a deep.
No, that's a very intense.
I mean, based on what I've seen my right. friends' parents be, they're either, because it was Hong Kong, bankers or like in the diamond business if they were Indians. Mm. And then a lot of like Indian kids' parents were in that diamond business. Or for example, our dad is in construction. So that's why we were there.
Okay.
For his project, one of his projects.
Han Hotel. I mean, the other one.
Han Hotel?
Yeah, the one in Dubai.
I think Rick, I don't know. That Rick doesn't... Rick,
you got abusive parents.
Well, no, it's because Rick just seems like you got blue-collar genes. You know what I mean? Like, yeah. Like I so just feel
Pittsburgh.
Like... But that's the storyline. I feel like your parents were like blue-collar family that created like a huge Duck Bookie franchise. You know what I mean? They blew up.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
You're like the good kid
right.
hanging with the rich kids.
I like that.
You know
well,
what I mean?
Well, that's like the driver... The driver kid,
yeah.
You know,
is that
the parents'
storyline?
Driver.
Well,
yes.
I didn't
that's
watch
actually,
it. I wanted to bring a whole new perspective.
Yes. Yes.
But that kid looks very, does not look like him. But
yeah.
This is like the real authentic version.
Right.
Yeah, because he's there for with a scholarship. That's how he's there.
He's like the smart guy.
Well, let's not spoil it. Let's not spoil it because a lot of people are going to watch
Shut
it.
The
Oh, don't spoil it for me, guys.
Okay.
No, I am gonna watch it.
Yeah.
But I gotta watch it. I know these guys. I gotta watch the thing. It's always fun watching, you know, your friends on the screen. Like I like you, just even talking to you so early on about your goals and your pursuit of this dream, and then seeing you on the biggest and seeing your numbers grow bigger than mine on my Instagram.
It is crazy.
That's his nightmare, by
the
way.
It's not a nightmare. No. I want my friends.
No, he's supportive.
I want my
like...
friends to thrive, but right below me.
Yeah.
No, that's very true. I'm kidding.
I know.
You saw your numbers into numbers.
I have 270,000 followers. If you got 260,000, that's the sweet spot, you know? But no, you're at 370,000 and growing. No, I'm kidding.
There must be a lot of imposter syndrome if it's all of a sudden in a few days. What's going on? You're still the same person as before, but what is this? Tell me, what is that experience
so
quickly?
Imposter syndrome just when I got the role.
Mm. Yeah.
I was like, I really was, which is why it meant so much to me what you guys said earlier, because it was so stressful to prepare for this role because we had a month in Korea and I just was like you said, like I feel like a very different person to the character, and it was like, how do I bridge this gap without pushing the like caricature of a queen bee, you know? Like it too close. It went back and forth like this until I guess I kind of like met in the middle. But even with the director, they were like, I think you're leaning too far this way. And it was just like
finding the balance.
Fuck. I was like, oh my God, I don't know
well,
my character. I was freaking out.
You know, when you're saying that, that first scene, right? When you're in the limo, I feel as if like you're right that if I imagine an American queen bee, it feels very different than what you played, which felt a little more Korean drama queen bee.
And plus, it was kind of fresh at the same time. Like,
yeah.
You don't see that typical...
Yeah.
It was in between. And I was curious about that. Did they ask... Were they like, hey, for your characters, we want it to be a little more K-drama? Like, did they say anything like that?
No.
Or more American... Because that would be so confusing.
Neither.
Not in terms of like Korean or American, but I think just in terms of like, it was, I don't know, it was really stressful. Which is
you killed it.
You killed it.
Thank you.
Seriously,
I was like, it was a day before I was supposed to go into show. I was like, oh, fuck, I don't know her. Like, I don't think I know her.
I only saw the
job.
First episode and you come out swinging hard.
Yes.
You have a presence immediately.
You really do.
I swear to you. And I was really shocked because that's not like kind of the person I know in real life.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like really, really impressed.
Well, if you get into the third or fourth episode, you start noticing the
it's
the
for
sweet
journalism
side.
Purposes. I will not continue to watch the series. Okay, I'm gonna keep asking these questions from a first episode perspective.
Wait, then you don't know all the twists.
No, we don't know yet. Yeah, I'm at like second episode.
And you don't get to see her develop into a different person. There are other elements, layers to this person.
Wait, Steffie, did you finish till episode 10?
I didn't finish it all the way because
Where are you up to?
I hate finishing things when I really get into it because, you know, you have to savor it. Like, if you do it at one time, I feel like I'm not doing it.
Oh, the binge culture of it?
Yeah. I don't like purposely doing it.
Yeah, no, because I'm like, there are really like big kind of 반전.
Yeah.
In the later episodes. So I'm like, do I want to talk about it?
No, don't spoil it. The show's not even a week old.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's not even a week old.
I wonder how that feels. Like, how long did it take you to make the show? Like, how long was shooting?
3.5
No, so like 15 weeks.
Isn't it crazy how now with Netflix, people could watch that in one day?
I know. It was crazy.
Like, you
know?
Oh, God. Yeah.
Like with beef, too. So like, it's just, I can't imagine.
It's like, whoa. Like, I wake up the next morning and some people have binged it already. It's like,
I just said I can't imagine it, but I can, because as a musician, like, we make albums and then like there's new stuff coming out every day.
Once it's dropped, you just let the whole load out.
Yeah,
you know.
But how did it?
Whole load out.
How did it feel for you hitting 1 million plus followers?
Okay, I mean, first before the million, I think the followers when it gradually grew, it didn't. It was just everyone was asking like, "Wow, like, are you look at your followers? Like, it's crazy." I'm like, "What do you? How do you feel?" I'm like, like, it's just a number at the end of the day. But I think it hit me once.
Such a posh thing to say. It's just a number.
I hate this character.
But honestly, that's the thing. I didn't really feel much until I, the other day when I went for this like shaved ice cream, like bingsu, the Korean ice. I went to Koreatown. I was in this cafe, and then these two teenagers and one of this little kid with the mother recognized me and asked for a photo. I was like, oh my gosh, I got recognized. That is so crazy. Aww. And ever since that, anywhere I go, like in a restaurant or somewhere, I might be feeling like cautious here, but I can feel someone side-eyeing me constantly. Yeah. That's when I realized like, oh damn, like this is like now getting a bit real here. Like now,
that's crazy. I feel that too. But nobody's there. Like, I'll feel that, and I'll eat all Moshike, right? And then I look over, and it's somebody looking the other way. And
but let me ask you this, because we've talked about this. You know, you wanted to be an actress, and you know that comes with this, right? Mm-hmm. It comes with the fame, right? Mm-hmm. And it kind of, all of a sudden thrown into you really fast. Mm-hmm. Now it's like, since Thursday, you're gonna get recognized.
Mm-hmm. Heck yeah.
More than any time you have in the past. Mm-hmm. And is it something that you can get used to now? Like you've got a hint of it?
I mean, I expected him to get recognized really quickly because his growing was really fast.
And, oh, okay.
You know, it made sense. I was like, when he told me he got recognized, I was like, oh, like that makes sense. You know, it's Koreatown. A lot of young kids are watching it. I didn't expect to get recognized. Like, I went to yoga. It was like the third day after the show came out. I went to yoga, as I always do, at the same studio. And the front desk girl recognized me. Like, are you an actor? And then I was like, oh, okay, yeah. And then he's like, oh, I watched the show yesterday. I was like, oh, my God, thank you. And then, like, you know, no makeup. Like, I was just, like, not prepared for anyone to recognize me. Going to Starbucks the same day. And then the barista is like,
let's go. Yeah,
I watched the show
Starbucks
yesterday.
Starbucks in it. I was like, yeah, you made it.
Yeah, Starbucks.
Starbucks recognized
you. I'm not expecting it at all, you know, because it's, like, so new.
Wait till you go to Tom and Tom's.
Wait, at Starbucks? At Starbucks, was she Korean?
No, she was Asian though.
Okay, cool. Yeah. When non-Koreans can recognize you, that's huge.
I promise you, way more non-Asians are watching the show than Asians.
Absolutely.
So it's gonna be crazy. No, it's gonna be like, good. You know, yeah. I don't know.
Let me ask you.
I think
you
even for Beef, I think it was like interesting to know that they're, you know, I hung out with some of the cast members and I noticed people were recognizing them and they were all white people. And I was like very excited about that. Yeah. It was just like, oh, like it's happening.
So when you get a million mm-hmm. on your IG, DMs and then Jenin, like you can't even check the inbox, right?
Oh,
like how does that work?
There's absolutely no way now.
It's because it's flooded now.
That's absolutely, yeah. So I can, so the other day I had to go on my settings and just turn on for the notifications for the people I follow.
Right.
And all the other DMs,
yeah,
it just goes into like requests or anything else. But Yeah, nowadays, if my friend from high school and I forgot I follow her or something like that, if she DMs me, there's no way I could.
It's gone.
It. It's like there's absolutely no way.
The drop in the ocean.
Yeah.
Like if I go on my Instagram, like I get like I don't get the notification except I get this. The vibration from my phone.
Yeah.
And I was like, what is this? It turns out it's a DMs that constantly comes in.
That's crazy.
That's when I realized, like, yeah, there's no way I can see.
But you know what's useful about things like that? Because I've noticed in general, you know, that
you get that feeling too?
No. Well, here's the thing. YA shows, right? Like Riverdale and things like that. Those get crazy amount of follows on social media. You know, our friends like Ross Butler, Charles Melton, like, you know, these guys on these YA shows.
You called it. You were like, you're going to.
Oh, yeah. Because I know how that goes. You know what I mean? And but it's funny. All those dudes, the good looking dudes, like they have to also like post stuff. Not necessarily on purpose, but they have stuff that's so different from their character.
Yeah.
You know, they're alone in the park reading a book and shit. I'm so not like the character on television, you know? Like, and then the followers go even crazier. Right. Like, oh my God. He doesn't realize.
He's intellectual.
Yeah. So it adds to the shit. And I feel like they're going to probably see some sides of you, maybe if you are different from your character, which I still don't believe.
I think they like that he's similar.
In a way, yeah.
You should play that up even harder. I'll play it up even harder. I mean, double down.
There are times when, like, on the comments, I would be playful. I would just play my character and imagine if I was Minho, then that's how I would reply. Sometimes I do that.
Yeah.
But I think I would say, because it's just playful. At the same time, people love it.
But you're good at that.
Yeah, but at the same time, it's also like, I would say that character was me when I was young. Except I didn't have the confidence.
That makes sense.
I didn't have the confidence when I was young.
Yeah.
Like talking to girls and whatnot and being athletically and academically inclined and everything. I was dumb as fuck.
But that's you know what? You're right though. They do in these high school shows, they do play up like they focus on a lot of the most confident characters.
Yeah.
You know, dudes in high school back in the day. All the confident dudes, we did have confident dudes like that in high school.
Yeah.
But now they have like 8 kids and
right.
Yeah, they had their first kid. They had the first kid in senior year. You know what I mean? So it's a little bit different.
100%.
Yeah. But it's I really like that. I like seeing Korea as a backdrop of something like this.
Yeah.
And that they didn't try to play it off, as Korea. And you guys got to work in Korea. Was it an American production company out there? Or was it Korean?
It was both.
Wow, that's cool.
It's a K-drama in Hollywood. It was a collaboration.
That's cool. Really interesting because they both work so differently.
I loved it.
I'm sure the crew had a really difficult time. Like, I've heard some, like, you know, communication. Their styles of working are very different.
Right.
And it's just, it was not easy for them at all. But they made it work.
I bet. What Korean team is like, what the fuck's a union? No, we're going to keep shooting.
Yeah.
We're shooting all through the night. Lunch break.
What did the...
Just eat a ramen and move it. Come on.
Yeah. It's a lot better now.
Did you guys
get
to choose your outfits? Have any...
a little bit.
Bit of your own essence.
We had a wardrobe, and then we would try it on and be. If we really didn't like something, obviously,
we would tell them. I had a lot of opinions as well. I was like, if they gave me this neon jumpsuit, and I was like, I look like a jelly bean with that. and then they're like, it reminds me of that jelly bean. They're like, oh, and then the wardrobe outfit manager, whatever, she didn't care. She was like, completely understandable, we'll move on.
Right.
But I loved how we could say things on the spot and they were
that's
welcoming
dope.
For that.
Yeah,
but
that's
I felt like in Korea, if we were to do that, they would be like,
그냥 입어.
In a way, I feel I think that would have happened that way.
I don't know.
Did you guys have relationships in high school? Like, did you have a boyfriend and a girlfriend or whatever?
Yeah.
Why do they both sound like it didn't end well? Like, for both of you guys, like,
I know.
You're like, yeah, she broke my heart into a million pieces.
Gia, is that why you have 5 different names? You know what I mean? Like, what would you do?
In a
past life.
One of my lives.
Yeah,
we did. Sang-hun more than me, I think. Right? No?
Why are you throwing me on the bus?
It's not a bad thing.
All right,
I didn't have my first proper boyfriend until I was 17.
That's pretty average. Yeah, you know? Yeah, it's not like late bloomer, you know? I didn't have a real girlfriend till like after that, I think.
Dude, that but sucks that for was... the boyfriends before 17. It's like proper boyfriend.
No, because
I thought we had something.
Like he was like my first like hold hands, like first yeah. kiss, like yeah. all of the firsts. Wait, is you it... know?
Oh. Yeah, give him no shine, bro.
Oh, like, so that's really...
She's like, I'm not giving him a shout out. I'm a Netflix star now.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
It's like, f*** you, Paul.
Oh man.
That's yeah. So I mean, I'm just asking because you know these are relationships in this international school.
And, yeah. Oh,
okay. Would you have rather been these characters that are in the show versus who you are, actually were in high school?
I wish. See, I could answer that straight away because I wish I was that character when I was young.
Mm. Yeah.
Because he had so much confidence, mm. and back then I didn't really even if someone like stepped all over me, I didn't say it on the spot. I didn't. Like,
yeah,
like vocalize myself yeah, yeah. basically. Yeah, so I would have loved it if I had that
wow.
confidence. Then yeah. I would have turned up maybe a bit more better, you know, in a better sense of character in a way.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But yeah, but at the same time, I'm glad that I made all those mistakes because mm-hmm. I learned from them and I don't let people walk over me.
Yeah.
And
sure.
I vocalize myself. Excellent. I say if I love it, I hate it. It's mm-hmm. just so, yeah, in a way, it's all great, but. Maybe if I was a bit more confident back then,
wow.
yeah. things would have been more interesting, basically.
Interesting.
True.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, YURI is a really... I learned from her in the sense that... So I think she found me because I needed something from her. And the thing that I learned from her is just having boundaries.
Mm.
Because I also didn't know my boundaries in high school.
Yeah.
And, you know, just taking up space is something that she can do really well, which is something that I still have to consciously work at, even if I'm even though I'm an actor. So that I really admire about her, you know, being like, look at me, I'm in this
that's
space,
fun.
Right?
That's fun for you to, you know, have that challenge and yeah. step into a role that you might not be fully comfortable
exactly.
with.
Exactly. Yeah. That was one of the challenges, I think. But also, like, specifically YURI, she's a very... unhappy girl,
mm-hmm.
so I don't think I would want to split places with her, but I definitely learned things from her.
Why did you feel like you couldn't take up space back in the day? Because I mean, I could say for myself, just, you know, being, I think, conditioned in this Korean sense, right,
mm-hmm,
of
mm-hmm.
being in a place where I feel like I need to exist in safety,
mm-hmm.
or like being kind of neutral or being, you know, caring,
right.
these yeah. types of roles is what I was told I was supposed to be like, to be a good Korean as an American as well.
Yeah.
So for me, that's what, how about for yourself? Do you?
I mean, so it's interesting growing up in an international school. Actually, the one that I graduated from was different from the one that I went to like in middle school and elementary school. But the one I graduated from was very heavily Asian. Mm. So that was actually really good. But then in middle school and elementary school, like I just moved there. I didn't speak the language well. And like that, you know, obviously was a blow to my confidence at school. And then like, I think I kind of became a little bit into my corner a little bit during that time. I was fine in Korea and like wherever else.
I totally didn't think that's how international school was. I thought there was like 50 lunch tables like the United Nations. You know?
We are India. Yeah. We are Korea. Yeah. The UK.
It's like,
yeah, everyone's just equally represented. And I was like, that must be cool.
I think it's definitely a cultural thing. Like, we're more told to like be more of the listener. Like, don't be too much in the center of attention.
Yeah.
You know?
No, but although he did that reminded me, during the lunch tables and everything, or if there are people hanging out, you would see Koreans hanging out with Koreans.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, that's natural in a lot of...
The click out happens.
Yeah. I mean, we used to always... There's always was like an Asian tree in high schools.
Mm, yeah.
Like,
the tree.
There's always... I don't know why it's a tree. Asians are drawn to a tree, apparently.
What do you mean?
Like, that the tree... Like, oh, meet at the Asian tree.
All
the literal tree.
Yeah. No, it wasn't like a bonsai. It wasn't like a little bonsai we just hung out at. No, it was a tree that all the Asians hung out by.
Yeah,
it wasn't like a little like a Korean pear tree that just like it was it was just the area where we would meet or something.
I know what you mean.
The bonsai. Go by the bonsai. And we're all picking at the bonsai.
All the elves are near the Christmas tree.
Yeah.
I just quickly want to thank you. You're one of the rare guests that brought us a gift.
Yeah.
This is very nice of you. What is it? What is it?
Our mom baked it.
Your mom baked it?
Yeah. Isn't that sweet?
It's so, omoni cookie?
Yeah. Omoni cookie, yeah.
Wow.
It's oatmeal, sesame seed. Like it's very healthy, like not much sugar.
Are
in
they
it.
In Korea? Where are they?
Yeah, they're in Seoul.
Oh, so they made the little heart joints.
Yeah. And there's a little note here. Oh. Thank you, Fun With Dumb team.
Let's go,
so
baby.
Cute.
From Gia and Sang Heon.
You guys are superstars and you still brought us gifts. That's what I'm talking
these
about.
These are like very healthy cookies, but they're really good. Sweet.
That's because it hasn't catch up to them yet. We'll see them in a year.
Yeah,
that's
true.
No,
you
I
guys
mean,
better stay grounded.
I've seen you guys' show. Like, I mean, Fun With Dumb podcast is the only thing that like I would like sit and watch YouTube. You know?
Really?
Like, yeah,
wow.
I would not do that for anything else on YouTube.
But I fucking laughed so hard when he pulled like glass top noodles. Like, I was like, wait, what was happening?
Yeah.
That is really him.
Yeah, that's me. That's me, baby.
Oh, these are good. These are really good. I love healthy shit. So.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, it's
Mama,
really, you can have it like for breakfast too.
Thank you
not
so much.
Much. Yeah.
Wait, does she have a bakery or?
No, she got a baking certificate, and so then she's that, been just.
You need to get certified to be a baker now.
Yeah, Taegyeopjeong.
Like a pro.
Yeah, like to be a pro.
And she got these bags.
I know.
Yeah.
What the heck?
Little druggy bags.
Wait, have your parents been like nicer to you since being on the show? How is the
No, I came out so wrong. When he said like nice to you, I was like, no. I said like there was no difference.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, she's always nice.
But she was always
she's very like on Instagram now. Like,
oh, that worries me so much.
What do you mean?
She like follows all the fan pages and like sends us
what
fans
are. She's proud of you guys.
She's that's great.
She's really excited, so we're happy that she's excited.
Yeah, but I'm a little worried sometimes. Because like she might see these comments and be very upset, but really we don't give a shit. But then that's when we're like, Mom, just don't rely too much on Instagram.
Because they might not understand the internet fully. Like
exactly.
That.
That's very good.
Funny. Yeah. My mom actually this weekend I hung out with her and she's like, what did this boy mean from the comments on YouTube
about this?
And they're like, she's like, oh, they're so mean. And I was like, oh, don't read that. It's not real.
Yeah.
So I totally get that they would, feeling worried about it.
I hate that, man. I don't like anybody who makes like super mean comments. Yeah. Has this experience made you guys even closer?
Yeah.
I'm so glad that she was with me in this journey because it's just there are times when I want to talk about things just towards like family, but maybe if it's work or if I have to keep it a secret, then it's just frustrating. But then there were so many things that we could talk about and relate to, and then it became like there were times where I'd be like, Gia, give me a hug. Like it's been a long day, and then we would be like great about it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I'm so glad that she was with she was with me the whole time.
Yeah. I mean, because we're 4 years apart, and I want to say this right now because the internet's getting all my age like all over the place. Sang-hun is 27.
Just turned 27.
Just turned it like over the weekend. I'm 30. I'm turning 31 this year, and my birthday is not April. It's November 4th, 1992. I'm a Scorpio, not a Taurus.
Wait, what's the internet doing? What are
they
doing?
They're
fucking up. That's the website just like decided they're going to make up my birthday as April something 1994. And then since then, everyone is quoting that website. Being like, she is blah, blah, blah. So.
And then obviously your side will get so pissed off because she was a reporter back then. So she's like, how can you not fact check this and just blur it out, mate?
That's
like,
fake news, straight up.
Yeah. So she got so pissed off. She was like, what?
I mean, not about my birthday, but like getting his name spelled wrong. And saying that it's just, that's a really big pet peeve of mine. It's just like, it's written there. Like, just type each letter out. You know, there's
it's
no
so disrespectful.
It like, is. It's like
it is. Your Google needs to step it up. I think I don't even see your cast picture, right?
Oh yeah. No.
What's going on right now? That pissed me off.
You guys all have a pretty international background too, though, right? Like you were born.
I was born in Argentina.
Argentina. And Buenos you Aires. Have a Brazilian flag on your. Did you grow up? In
yeah,
Brazil
I
too?
Actually did grow up. Ever since I was a kid, I would go to Brazil twice a year because that's where my grandparents immigrated to.
Oh.
Yeah, from Korea. Well, my grandpa was in Japan and then immigrated back to Korea, and then they all moved to Brazil. So I would go to Brazil to learn about my Korean heritage.
And Rick's Virginian.
I'm from Virginia.
Virginian. Yeah,
yeah,
and he's Virginian.
Shigoseki, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah. No, yo, I want to thank our guests here. Yeah. Gia Kim, Sang Heon Lee. Sorry.
You motherfucker.
I know.
You got it right.
I mean, I feel like it's going to be interesting. I'm so curious to see where your careers go off into various projects. You know, like I mentioned before, I met Gia when her follower count was less than 300 people. Some would say I discovered her.
Oh my God.
Jesus.
It's not necessarily true, but some would say that I discovered her. And very proud of you, Gia.
Thank you.
Honestly, I'm very proud. And it's like, it's a really testimonial to see, you know, that all this is really possible.
Yeah.
You know, literally met her and she was just talking about her going to acting school and, you know what I mean? And pursuing this. She was crying out of nowhere. It was insane.
Oh, I cried then. Oh, I see.
No, I don't know. It was just crying various throughout the day. Yeah, it was various occasions.
I saw you crying at Cry Later. I see.
Yeah. It's like, can you cry later after the show? No, there's a lot of crying. But nice. Amazing. And Sang Heon, I think clearly you're taking off.
The internet is going.
Why do you think you've gotten all these crazy followers? I mean, obviously, there's the girl fan base of the girls who watch the show who are obsessed with you.
Yeah, but
dog,
I'm gonna say this though. Like, honestly, like, if you put a lie, if there is a lie detector test, I could do it. I don't consider myself that good looking. Mm. So that's why when people love me, I'm like, I told Gia, I was like, that is weird how they love me. Like,
oh, great. That just got you another 100,000 followers. Here we go.
He's so humble.
Yeah, it was handsome like, and humble. Hashtag handsome and humble. Here we go.
I think they love the character Minho. I'm not sure about me as a person, but they love the character. So I think Jenny and like Sasha, the whole EXO family, they made that character so well. Yeah. So I'm just glad that I portrayed that character lovable. So I'm just thankful for that. Really,
I like you guys more since I've seen you guys here. Like, you guys are so well-rounded.
Yeah,
you know, and it is different from the show. So like, I like that. I was like, I feel so comfortable. You guys are so great.
You guys are genuinely just great people.
I could be here all day talking to you guys, and I just also really want to say I really, really appreciate being here because I know the. I'm like after Dumbfoundead, I'm not gonna cry.
If you cry, we'll get more views, man. Make it happen.
You cry right now, you're going to get a season two. I said, give it a go. Look right in the camera and cry. She can turn that on, I'm telling you.
Can you do it too?
No, I can't cry like
right now.
Right now?
No, I can't. I mean, I don't like doing that either because but I just want to say I appreciate being here and having us here because I know the people who have been on this show and. Like I said, I'm like, I don't know if I deserve to be sitting here, but like, thank you for having us here and
Let's go!
Season two, here we go!
Let's go!
It just means so much also because I really like each and every one of you and I really liked Dumb because, I want to tell this story because it's one of the sweetest things that anyone's ever said to me.
I don't think you remember. What did I say? I love hearing about myself. What did I say?
He like all stood up and
I said something sweet? I got to keep track of these things because I rarely do it. So,
well, at the 88 Rising after party, you don't remember, probably don't remember. But you remember seeing me there?
I do.
Okay.
Was that a Mama Line?
Yeah, okay.
So, I was drunk. But
yes.
No, that doesn't mean that take away from the sweet. Right, go.
And then like we were just like chatting, I guess, and then you're like, I'm like, what? He's like, oh yeah, yeah. I was like, what? And by then I would kind of give up, right? But I really wanted to know what you were saying.
Yeah.
So I asked you the third time, and you said, I would cast you in any show.
Wow.
I was like, that is like the big. biggest compliment to an actor. Obviously, it's not realistic, but also it's just like, that is just so sweet.
Wow.
That
you would say I didn't hear the rest of it. I said, except any of mine.
Okay. Of course, no, of course. No,
was,
no,
it
of
was
course.
Really sweet. And also because you were drunk, I was like, I know he, like, this coming from some kind of truth down there.
No, because sure. because I respect anyone who works on their craft as much as you do. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And then the tears. Forget about it.
You do have a brightness. You like when you walk into a room, there's a brightness to you. Seriously, yeah, you know, you're like a Philips Hue.
You know? No, but also Steffie, like I watched you on the show, and I love how real you are. You just like and. I went on your Instagram too, and it's just like you're this empowered woman who loves to empower other women, and I love seeing women like that. So
100%. Thank you. You know what? I always tell that to Steffie. Yeah. I'm glad there's an extra person just adding on to that.
For real.
No, for real. Like, I really, really, I was like, oh my God, she is such a cool person. Like, yeah. I'm so excited to meet her.
Oh,
like,
thank you so much. That's why I was really excited. Yeah.
That's so nice. That's so nice.
And Rick, like, you are just. Like you just said, you light up
those
a room.
Three likes,
too.
There was a stutter there.
No, seriously, like Rick, you just like every time I went to intercruise something, you like just make me feel so comfortable, even though we hadn't met that many more times in person or like personally or anything. So like each one person I've was like, they are really good human beings, and I'm just so
you're gonna make me cry.
I want to see you cry, actually.
I know a lot of people. It's really a hard thing. I might need Rick to shoot me or something. Trying to get me to cry, because it's not an easy task. Yeah. But that's why I'm so jealous. Like, I really, really, I seen, what's that actress on? She was on Conan. Her name's Dallas Bryce. You know Bryce Dallas?
Or, nah, I don't.
You know that? She cried on the spot on cue, and it was really impressive.
Mm. Yeah.
So I always like think like, good actors can cry on the spot.
No, I don't think so. I think that's overrated, like crying.
Oh, really?
Like I think
all right,
well, yeah, I think, you know, yeah, I think being like comedy is harder. I guess it's different for other people, but like for me personally, I feel like being like having that comedic timing and leaning into your instincts and trusting everything happening and not overthinking everything, like that is more impressive than like crying in a scene. To me personally.
Wow. Okay. Well, I'm not going to cry then. Well, what is there any other projects? You guys are promoting EXO Kitty, so I don't want to take the shine away, but you guys are working on some other stuff, I assume? Like, things are looking good? Or
no, so hit us up. Like, we're not busy
Let's
right
do
now.
It,
so.
Yeah, I mean, I'm sure it's gonna be great. I mean, this is less than a week into the show.
So good.
I appreciate you guys hopping on, you know, this long format
Seriously.
Podcast. You know.
No,
I love what
so
you guys are
fun.
Doing for the culture.
We were actually looking so forward to this because we're like, this will be our first podcast and again,
first
this
sibling appearance on a podcast.
Mm-hmm. Let's go.
Like, that is not EXO Kitty Press.
Yeah.
This is like the first thing that we're doing without our publicists here, like without the whole hair and makeup.
Another right now. Please, that dumbfounded guy. He always brings the worst out of people.
It would only be possible because it's this podcast and I know you and like
Damn.
I've watched this show and my publicist is like, do you want us to come with you? I was like, nah, it's fine. Like this is not one of those things, you know.
I
just
appreciate
was
it.
Really
That's
looking
amazing.
Forward to coming.
Thank you.
I
thank
appreciate
you.
It. Well, thank you
thank
guys.
You.
Gia Kim and Sang Heon Lee, ladies and gentlemen.
Let's go.
And tune in next week for another episode of Fun with Dumb. Go watch EXO Kitty. Peace.
Wow.